So I'm here with Taite Hensley. He's a member of the Lower Columbia Baseball Club and also a member of the Kelso Highlanders, who just took second place in state. So Taite, right off the bat, tell me about your experience for this season in high school, also kind of the run you guys had through the playoffs.
Yeah, so I had probably one of the greatest experiences playing with Kelso of my baseball life this year. I started out not looking at it as a starting position or anything like that, but worked my tail off, finally got up to be in the outfield. Got a pitching opportunity against Bonnie Lake in a seeding game to save arms. Went 5 1/3, no hit or something like that. And then after that, I started pitching in the bigger games. Kept doing good, kind of proved myself there. So it was just a great season from going from the bottom to up to the top. And then we rode it all the way to second place. So it was fantastic.
Yeah, that takes a lot of work, a lot of effort. And, kind of tell me about your experience in the championship game with the time you got to play in that one.
It was unreal. The amount of people that were there from everywhere, it was just crazy. It's a different feeling when you're up on the mound and you can hear everyone cheering. And some people I've never even met before came up to me and told me they'd been following me all season long and stuff like that. So it was just crazy, and it was just awesome.
You know, and here you are with the Lower Columbia Baseball Club, and kind of looking forward to the future, trying to determine what you're going to do next year. Kind of what are your hopes and plans with baseball as you just finished your senior year and playing this summer?
Yeah, so this summer I'm really looking to just get in contact with a lot of colleges. I really just want to play. I don't really care who I play for, where I play, or what position I play. I just want to play. I love the game. So I've been looking at Centralia College has been talking to me. I'm trying to get in touch with LCC, and then Central Washington University was another one on my list that I was looking at going to. So,
yeah, some great programs there to look at. And then, you know, to make it that far, to even make it as far as you've made it so far, you got to have that someone who's, or those individuals who are in your life and really push you. So who in your life's kind of been your inspiration and kind of your motivator behind the scenes?
Yeah, so big thanks to Dennis Mackey. He's been my pitching coach for the last 2 years. I know he worked with Yancey Bird and his son before that, Jason Mackey, but he kind of took me under his wing for free and just wanted to work through me, I guess, and continue to live his dream of just baseball in general. So huge thanks to him, and then all of my coaches from the younger level just helping me just love the game and just keep going.
And then also looking at things, you know, for a lot of players, especially younger ones, you'll pick up on a major league player, someone who you've kind of maybe not copied, but kind of like you enjoyed their work ethic, their style. Is there a player you've kind of looked at over the years and said, you know, I kind of want to be in the same mold as that individual?
Yeah, so for a long time when I was younger, it was Noah Syndergaard, but more recently it's been Mitch Haniger. He's just crazy, probably one of the most underrated ball players out there. He's just unreal, and so he's been my guy.
Yeah, Mitch Haniger with the game-winning home run last night. So definitely a good choice. I love that guy as well. Also kind of looking at this summer, you know, you talked about trying to look at schools, that type of thing, but what are you looking at from a baseball perspective to try and work on and focus on this summer?
So I've been really working big on my mechanics lately and hitting spots as far as pitching goes. As far as hitting goes, it's just I feel a lot better when I come up to the plate with more confidence and not let hit my pitches. Mm-hmm. Basically, early in counts, don't get a lot of breaking balls. I'm not the greatest curveball guy. And then in the outfield, it's just anything in the air I like to catch. So whatever I can do out there it's all my mental.
And then last question I have for you, you know, here you are, just finished high school, or actually you're about to graduate. And, you know, looking at the kids who are younger, little leagues, that type of stuff, what advice would you have for them as they're looking to play high school ball and maybe even play college level?
Yeah, just work as hard as you can. If it's what you want to do, put in the work off time as well as during practice. The coaches definitely notice, and eventually you'll get your chance, and you just got to make the most of what you get. So that's my big advice, big tip.
Awesome. Well, thank you very much. Yeah.